Now, with this clip here, it would be really nice to kind of, we want to push her up a little bit further into the corner of the frame. So I'm just going to go up, and I'm going to click my cropping control. This allows me to either trim the clip, I can crop it, I can even do a Ken Burns effect where I can pan across the video really easily. I'm going to select crop, and I'm just going to come in here, and I'm going to bring my crop control in, move her up, done. She's kind of cropped over onto the side, a couple of clicks. But now, I've got some footage underneath of this car. It'd be nice if I actually animated this up and across. So all I'm going to do is just choose a frame. I'm going to bring up my keyframing controls and add one keyframe at this point. I'll move my playhead a little bit earlier. Now I'm just going to grab the center of the frame, drag it over. I get nice guides to show me where the centers are. Then that automatically puts in a keyframe. I'm going to go earlier, and I'm going to pull this down. Pull it down. And I get a nice Bezier path there. I can also say that I just want that to be a linear path. And so now, when I do this, we'll see this come up and move over. Just like that, keyframing directly in the timeline. But one of the things I notice here is that as this is kind of going across, notice the clip underneath ends, and we see a flash of that interview shot coming back in there. So what I can do is I can click here, and I can show my animation graph. So I can actually see all of the keyframes in place in the timeline. So for example, I can grab this keyframe, and I can drag it back over here to where that clip underneath still exists. And so now, I no longer see that flash of that other clip underneath. I can see everything in context.